Hello and welcome to this Microsoft DevBox demo video. Today I'm going to show off the new Config as Code feature for DevBox that's now in public preview. This feature allows you to define DevBox customizations using a simple YAML file format, which makes it even easier for you to customize your DevBoxes by automating common setup and onboarding tasks such as installing additional software, cloning repositories, setting environment variables, and more. Microsoft DevBox enables dev teams to create ready-to-code DevBoxes in the cloud based on VM images that you might already have. However, with the Config as Code feature, you can automate a lot of common setup and onboarding tasks, such as installing tools and frameworks for your development team. In this video, I am going to take you through setting up a customized DevBox end-to-end, including how to set up guardrails as a platform administrator, and how to enable your dev teams to customize their dev boxes within those guardrails. The first step is to create a catalog of tasks that your organization could use to customize your dev boxes. A catalog is a Git repository that defines the tasks that you could use in DevBox YAML files, and it allows platform administrators to control what tasks developers can use in their configurations, the guardrails. Think of them as the basic ingredients developers would use to make the configurations they would like. By default, we provide you with a quick start catalog that contains four different tasks, including winget, git clone, chaco, and a generic PowerShell task. Start here with just a few clicks to try out DevBox customizations. You could create your own catalog in the future. To use the quick start catalog, go to the Azure portal and navigate to your Dev Center. In the left menu, under Environment Configuration, select Catalogs, and then click Add. In Add Catalog, please pick Microsoft's Quick Start Catalog and DevBox Customization Tasks as the Quick Start Catalog type. Give your catalog a name and then select Add. You should see your catalog appear in the list. Congratulations! You now have a catalog of tasks that your developers can use to customize their DevBoxes. You can now create a YAML file that defines the customizations that you'd like to see in your DevBox, like the one here. This configuration file contains a task section where you could specify the task that you'd like to run on your DevBox to customize it. For example, my YAML file uses the winget task to install Visual Studio Code, and it uses the git clone task to clone the Orchid Core .NET web app repository onto my DevBox. To try this out, you could download this example file from our examples repository, sign into the Microsoft Developer Portal to create a new DevBox, and use the Add Customizations from File button to select this file. Congratulations! Your DevBox will be created with your base image and the customizations that you specified in your YAML file. To share this configuration with your team or project, you can also commit your customization as a workload.yaml file to your codebases in Azure DevOps. This will allow you to seamlessly create DevBoxes with that repository, but also with that configuration. And you could do this by pasting in the repository URL when creating your DevBox. Check out our announcement blog post to learn more about this feature and more. For example, you could learn about how you could use our VS Code extension that helps you author and iterate on your configurations. You could also learn how to use secret credentials within your configurations from a private key vault, allowing you to get access to private resources. You could also learn how to write your own tasks and how to use the power of winget config to port over existing DSC scripts that you might have to DevBox. Thank you for watching, and let us know what you think.